This video is all about reliable testing and flaky test. We've all been through it. We've been working in our code, and at some point, unexpectedly, a test fails. It was running before, nothing changed, and now it fails. We run it again, and now it works, so what gives? There's no apparent reason. We've been hit by a flaky test, one of the most frustrating and disruptive issues that developers have to deal on a daily basis. What do? Rerunning them until it passes is a meh solution. It doesn't fix the underlying issue. So today we're going to lay down a plan to manage them. So what is a flaky test and how it is different from any other kind of test? Well, actually, there isn't any difference. Any kind of test can be flaky. For example, an end-to-end test, a unit test, an integration test. The word flaky implies that the test is undependable, unreliable, or otherwise fragile. A flaky test is a test that passes and fails seemingly randomly. The code is the same, the environment is the same, but the test sometimes fails without any apparent reason. Flaky tests are a big issue for developers. A recent survey shows that flaky tests are common and serious, and they cause the loss of trust in test outcomes. I can think of three types of flaky tests. First, we have the typical flaky test that randomly fails on the same machine. For example, let's say I have a local copy of the project in my machine and I run my test suite and I notice that some tests are failing and then passing and then failing and I'm not making any changes. This type of flaky tests are probably the most difficult to debug because anything can be the cause. There might be some non-deterministic code, for example, relying on a date. There might be some async waits that are timing out or resolving in an order that we didn't expect. Everything that's async can be tricky to test reliably. If you have concurrent processes, they might be the cause for flakiness, again, because we cannot control the order in which actions take place. The same happens when we assume the test will run in a certain order and we set them accordingly. When we don't correctly isolate tests one from each other, the side effects from one can affect the other. The second type of flaky tests are environmental. It means that the test works in one environment 100% of the times, but when we change environment, it starts to flake, like the developer machine versus the CI/CD machine. The problem 90% of the time here is due to some subtle environmental difference between the test environment and the developer machine. It might be something as simple as a minor difference in the version in my runtime or in a dependency. It can be even be hardware related, like one machine has a different number of cores or more memory. It can even be related to networking issues, like some firewall or some API that's rate limiting us or has blacklisted the IP of our machines. The last type of flaky test is what I call branch flakiness. This is when a test passes 100% of the times in the feeder branch, but when we merge into the main branch, it starts to flake. Now, not everyone will agree with me with this definition, but I think if we are doing trunk-based development where we are merging into main constantly, we can assume that this type of errors can be flaky because the code has not changed, the test is the same, but the end result is the same. We have to debug it and find why it is flaking on the main branch. Careful comparison between the branches should reveal the cause of the issue. Even with all precautions, some tests will eventually flake. So here's my 3-step plan to handle flaky tests. So to get started, we need to get into the right mindset. While it might be tempting to retry the test until it passes, it's not going to work long term. Eventually, this test is going to bite us when we least expect it. So the best attitude is to just eat the frog and work on the test as soon as it starts to flake. If you can't fix it right away, then it will go into your technical debt pile. Open a ticket, document the issue, add as much detail as you can, and start working on it as soon as feasible. So our plan here is to fix the flaky test, but before we can do that, we must identify them. And that can be a totally different problem. In some cases, you will see the test flake in front of your very own eyes. You're running your test in your development machine and notice something odd. If you can't fix the problem right away, then do it. You're less likely to push flaking code into your repository. In most cases, However, you will detect flaky tests in your continuous integration system, which by its very nature continually reruns your test suite, so it's very likely to catch flaking tests. If you're lucky, your continuous integration provider will have some feature, some tool to single out flaky tests. Otherwise, you will have to sift to multiple runs and multiple builds in your CI history to identify these tests. Where I work in Semaphore, we have two features to help you identify these pesky tests. First, we have test reports, which combines the results of all your tests into one single dashboard. You can filter tests by category, see how many times they failed, and get a summary of the error message. Second, building on top of test result, we have the flaky test dashboard. Here we will find new flaky tests that were introduced recently. You can see how many tests a flaky test has disrupted your build, and a list of detected flaky tests, which you can filter, organize, and sort. You can also assign actions like open tickets or resolve them all in one place. After driving flaky tests out in the open, we need to start fixing them. If the issue is clear, you can fix them on the spot. But most of the cases, you will need more information. That means adding debugging information into your test to see what's going on. We should start by capturing as much information as possible about the issues. Sometimes even adding something as simple as console commands is enough to log and to realize what's going on. You can run your tests or scripts in the back both, which usually yields more information. Usually you can do that by setting up environment variables. Another tool you have is the built-in debugger. Here's how you use it with Node. And if the issue appears only on the continuous integration machine, you may need to SSH into that machine and run the test in the console so you can see the problem firsthand. One set of tests that frequently flake are UI tests. These are because UI is very fragile to test, and if you are doing end-to-end testing, you may need to capture the screenshots when something goes wrong. This will help us see what the test code saw during the execution. Here's how you can do it on Playwright, a popular UI testing framework. That's all for today. I hope this video helps you find your way through your flaky tests the next time you find them blocking your way towards a green build. Don't let your technical debt pile too high. If you have too many open tickets, maybe it's a good sign that you should set aside some time to fix them. And if you like this video, why not share it with that developer you know that's just used to rerunning the test until they pass? As always, giving us a like, subscribing, or following us helps a lot towards making more videos like this. Thank you so much for watching, and have a nice one.